You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk all about transforming RAG and search with Azure AI Document Intelligence. My friend Lou, make sure you tune in. Hello, and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're talking all about transforming RAG and search with Azure AI Document Intelligence. My friend Lou. Lou, it's been a while. How are you doing, my friend?
I'm doing well. How is everything going with you, Seth?
Fantastic. So for those who don't know who you are, why don't you tell us who you are and what you do?
Sure. My name is Lu Zhang. I'm the product manager working on Azure AI Document Intelligence, formerly known as Azure Form Recognizer.
That's amazing. So before we get started, I know we've had shows on Azure AI Document Intelligence before, but I was hoping maybe you could give us a little overview real quick.
Sure. Azure AI Document Intelligence is a cloud-based AI service that can help you extract text, key value pairs, tables, and document structures from your any type of your documents. This is the studio, a UX portal that you can explore the capabilities of the AI Document Intelligence. If you go to the layout model, you click on the Run Analysis, and you should be able to extract like the paragraphs, the sections, the table structure, as well as like selection marks and even like math formulas like from any type of your documents.
This is really cool. And so for clarity, this is any kind of documents, or what kind of documents are we talking about? Like just like text or other things?
Yes, they will be like Office files and HTML files.
So all sorts of goodness. Okay. And I know, so we're talking about RAG. Can you maybe spend a minute explaining to us like what RAG is and how it can be helpful? Because I'm trying to see if we can put these two concepts together.
Yeah, of course. This is a diagram of the RAG pattern, Retrieval Augmented Generation. Basically, when the user like ask a question to our like service, what you will do from the backend is use the query to relevant knowledge. Once you get the search result, you will combine the knowledge together with the query as part of the prompt to ask large language models and get the response. So this is how the Retrieval Augmented Generation works. That can mitigate the limitation of purely using the large language models with like a hallucination without any reference to an answer.
And this is a really good pattern because it allows people to, when they're asking questions, to actually search for information that goes into the prompt, but that's not necessarily getting into the model. It's just something that goes into the prompt. Is that right?
Yes, that's correct. And one of the biggest thing is like where you get all this like knowledge base. Most of the knowledge lives in document today. So that's why you would need the Azure AI Document Intelligence.
Yeah, and this is an important thing because I love how you brought the slide up with challenges in retrieval augmented generation. I get this question asked a lot about how to properly chunk the documents when you do indexing. It's kind of a challenge. Tell us about that.
Yeah, exactly. There have been a lot of questions asking about like how to do semantic chunking, because one of the challenges is if you use documents into like some arbitrary like based on length limit, it could like break down the semantics from the document. So one of the example you can see is if you ask a question about the long table from the financial report, you can probably get the answer if the row shows up in the beginning, but if it's like in later part of the table, because of the fixed length chunking, you will most likely not get the answer because the header of the table and the actual rows are separated in different chunks.
Exactly. And so now that we know what the problem is, everyone always asks me about the chunking strategy. Tell me about semantic chunking. You just put this slide up. Tell us how Azure AI Document Intelligence can help.
Sure. Yeah, as I just mentioned, Azure AI Document Intelligence can help you extract the content, the tables, and the document structure from different sources of the document. And what we offer later is like all these building blocks that can enable the customers to do any type of semantic chunking. You can define your own rules, like based on paragraphs, based on section headings, or based on like figures or hierarchical structure to like chunk your document based on your business needs. But more importantly, if you don't want to bother with all these like different building blocks, we offer the capability of output to Markdown format. This is a large language model friendly format, and you can easily also integrate with LangChain's Markdown splitter to do the semantic chunking.
Ooh, do you have an example of how to do that?
Yes, let me show a quick demo. So this will be, I think I will just use the layout concept page. I just download the PDF, and this is, as you can see, a long document. What I'm going to do is to index this document using the recent integration we have done with the LangChain. So the code will just be very simple. You just need to import this Azure Document Intelligence loader, and then load the document with the pass file, your endpoint and keys, and then further chain that with the Markdown header splitter with your defined headers to split on. And once that it is done, you will be able to get all the splits and further like embed that, all these chunks, and make that like indexed in your search database.
I see. Can you scroll? Oh, good. So you're going to show the code, because this is actually directly inside of LangChain is what I'm seeing. Is that correct?
Yes, exactly. So that's, you will see the output. This is the actual splits or the chunks we did. And this is based on the section headings. You will see like from the metadata, okay, this is the header of the section.
That's really cool. And so now you're actually, instead of getting some fixed window that you made and having to worry about overlap, you're getting semantic chunks that actually hopefully have meaning.
Yes, exactly. And that's in cool. This notebook, I also did one like with this like fixed length chunking with some overlap. So I will use that later in my demo to show the difference.
Oh, I see. So you're doing the semantic one, and you're doing just the regular, you know, fixed chunk with overlap.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, and in the notebook, I also pre-run that, and you should be able to like chain all these different pieces together and ask a question. For example, I will ask the question about the input requirement. So what type of document I should prepare for like a layout model to consume? And you will be able to get answer, okay, we support all different file formats, including PDF, image, office files, and HTML. And you will also get the detailed requirement about the dimensions, minimal and maximal dimensions. And if your PDF is locked, you should be able to like decrypt that before you send us.
That's really cool. So is there a way to make this work? Like, for example, if someone's using AI Studio, because I want to, you know, how do you put this all together in something like AI Studio?
Of course. As you can see, like here, I have split the document into chunks. And later, like I also use LangChain actually to make the index. So using the Azure AI search to store that in the vector store. So this one is using the fixed length. And I've also done one for Semantic to show how you can build a chat experience like about this document.
I love it. So at the same time, you're literally storing all of this stuff from LangChain directly into Azure AI Search.
Yes, exactly.
Correct. Okay, cool. All right, well, let's take a look.
Okay. Yeah, so now let's come to the Azure AI Studio, the playground. Basically, we are using Add Your Data to enrich the results of the large language model. So I put some system message here to make sure this is focusing on the Q&A task. And I also added the data, which I just made. This one is a simple index. And there's another one that's used the semantic chunking result as the index. So let's start with the first one, the simple index. And the question I will be asked is, could you please illustrate the expected output of the JSON? Because we talk about detecting section headings, so I want to learn like what it looks like. And as you can see, the model can actually get the answer with some sample JSON output. But we want to make sure this is not like doing any of the guess or hallucination. So let's check the reference. So the reference is actually like a point, like fixed length chunk with some overlap. And if you see this chunk end up with some like incomplete JSON output in the chunk. So that's why you see the we will tell you about like the actual correct answer later. But as you can see, if you infer from some incomplete chunks, you will probably get some like misunderstanding about like from the large language model.
100%.
Yeah.
So what does it look like with the good index?
Sure, let's look at the other one. So this one, we use the semantic chunking index and we put the same system message. And now let's ask the question again. What will be the expected outcome of the in the JSON then when there is a section heading detected? As you can see, so this one, we still have the row like of the paragraph detected as the section heading, the actual content, as well as like because we also give you the spans and the bounding regions, basically the bounding box of this paragraph. That one will also be useful when you build the actual RAG application. You can even like visualize where this paragraphs comes from the document. And let's further look at the citation here. This time, because we embed the whole section, so you see the JSON is complete and it is retrieving exactly the same thing from the original document. So that's like a showcase the difference when you are building a RAG or compare with like a simple chunking. Semantic chunking will be make your answer more accurate.
That's pretty amazing. So just a question about this stuff, because now that you're able to do semantic chunking, my sense is that there's probably more to be done. So what do we have to look forward to in this space?
Sure. Yeah, we keep pushing our model to help like with when you are building the RAG pattern. So besides what we currently offer, like the section headings, paragraphs, tables, what we are currently working on is to enable customers also detecting the figures, diagrams or charts within a document. Because like if you think about manuals or like financial reports, there could be lots of information hidden in the figures. So what will come soon will be like we tell you which region is a figure in a document, and you can further like crop the image and send the image to like GPTV or other models to understand the meanings of the figure. So that's one thing. And the other feature, which is also enhanced like the section detection, is we call it hierarchical document structure analysis. Basically, like we not only telling you this is a section heading, but as you can see the different colors, these are the different layers of the sections. So you will be able to tell this is a section versus subsection versus like a title. So once you know the hierarchical structure, you will be like further make your semantic chunking more accurate. So that these are the two important features we are working on, and that should be able like enable you build an even better RAG with semantic chunking.
Well, this has been awesome. So thank you so much. Where can people go to find out more?
Sure. Definitely get started like using our quick start with the studio aka.msdistudio. So you will be able to explore all the capabilities and feel free to reach out to us if you have any questions.
Awesome. And for the sample code, obviously it's just right there, aka.msdocgenai. So make sure you do that. So thank you so much for spending some time with us, Lou.
Yeah. Thank you, Seth.
And thank you so much for watching. We're learning all about how to transform your RAG and search with Azure AI Document Intelligence here on the AI Show. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.